Hello, David Clarke here from DVC, and I'm going to go through the new features that have appeared in EDIUS 8.3. The biggest thing is probably optical flow on slow motion, which should give you better quality slow motion on lots of shots. On top of that, we've also got a new mode in the bin. We've got some improvements to proxy editing in the Grass Valley browser, and they have done quite a lot of work on the interface to make it work better on a 4K screen. Finally, they've added in something which a lot of people will find incredibly useful, the ability to write DVDs and Blu-ray discs out of projects which aren't the right size. In other words, you can just convert it inside the DVD writer. Anyway, firstly, let's have a look at the optical flow. So I want to take this clip and slow it down. So you've got me at the desk there, and in walks a guy whose name is Ringo. And I'm going to take it, throw it onto the timeline, and I want to slow it down. So to do that, obviously, you just right-click and go to Time Effect and Speed, or Alt and E, which is a shortcut I do my best to remember because it's an awful lot quicker than digging down a couple of menus like that. And here you get the same dialog box that we've had for ages, which basically says, okay, what speed do you want it to run at? And if you change the speed, what happens to the clip? If I make it slower, then it's going to take 3 times longer. So do I make it get longer, or do I just use the first third of the clip? I'm going to leave it to make it last longer, and I'm going to type in 30%. So now that's running at about a third its original speed. This is exactly the same as it has been in EDIUS for ages. The new stuff is under field options. So let me just click on that, and here you can see the new things. We have 3 different methods of what they call interpolation. So basically, if I've slowed this thing down by a third, what does it do to fill in the gaps? Nearest neighbor basically repeats frames. So if I click on that and say OK, and then play it, you'll notice as he walks in, it's rather stuttery, not very smooth, basically repeating every frame 3 times. Let's pop back into that. I'm going to go right click on it and go to time effect. And rather than going to speed and then clicking that other button, I'm just going to go down here to field option, which gets me directly to this interpolation box. And I'm going to set it to frame blending. Now if I do frame blending and start playing that back, you'll notice the movement's a bit smoother. There's a kind of double image going on, and if you were looking at this on a proper screen and comparing this to the previous version, you might notice everything got a little bit fuzzier, because what frame blending does is it takes the clips and rather than just repeating frames, it crossfades them together. So it takes 3 or 4 frames and then blends them together to try and get a smoother slow motion. EDIUS has been doing that for years, and it actually does it really well. The new stuff is the optical flow. So let's just right click time effect field option, and you come down to this one, optical flow. And what optical flow does is it will actually make up stuff. So let's click on that and go OK. And what you can see there is you don't get that kind of double vision that I get with frame blending, and I get a much smoother looking slow motion. And basically there, actually, it looks really, really good. What it's doing is it's making up stuff. So the computer's analysing the movement and then trying to make up what should be added into this space. And sometimes it does a good job and sometimes it does a bad job. Now, this shot looks really, really good looking at it up in that small window. But if you made it bigger or popped it out to a nice 50-inch TV using a Blackmagic gizmo, you'll notice little what we call artifacts everywhere. Just things that aren't quite right. I mean, in particular, have a look at this area as his arm moves across past that computer. And also have a look around him, around the edges of him as he moves across these vertical lines. I'm going to pop it up full screen and just play it in a loop so you can maybe see some of the things that are wrong with this a bit better. So here we are, he comes in, and then you look at what's going around there, and there's a kind of space warp almost going on around that bit with his arm. There's a bit of juddering going on around here as he goes past these horizontal lines. So although the movement is sharper, bits of it aren't as good. What you've got to decide for yourself is whether you prefer that look or whether you prefer the frame blended look. If I set them up so you can see a direct comparison between the two, you can see the frame blending one here with that kind of double motion, but you're not getting any of that juddering as he goes past these vertical lines here. And here you can see the optical flow, which basically does look better in lots of ways, but not in others. You notice as he goes past there, as he goes past here, it's not quite as good. It'd be lovely if we could combine the two, but we can't. It's either frame blending or optical flow. And I found after testing out the optical flow, there's occasions when it does a really good job, and there's occasions when it does a bad job. Sometimes I find the results completely unusable. This one, I think I probably prefer this, even though the juddering around these vertical lines here isn't very nice. I think I probably prefer the optical flow. Now, before we have some more examples, let's also have a quick look at the timeline down here, where I've basically got the two things next to each other. And all I've done, obviously, is put the things on there, put the slow motion on it, and then just divided the screen so you can see both of them. But another thing you might notice is it's come up red. My computer is a Skylake system using the best quad-core i7 processor and 32 gig of RAM. Now, you can get better computers which have got Broadwell chips or Xeons in them, but this is kind of the average computer that we sell for using with EDIUS. And you'll notice it's flagged this up as rendering. It needs to render it. That's the optical flow. I mean, they've tried to make it so that the optical flow will play back in real time, and if I play it, you'll notice my buffer is actually climbing. So even though it's got a red line and thinks it has to render, no, it's actually playing it for me in real time, but it is harder. Doing optical flow is basically harder than doing regular frame blended slow motion. So you might find sometimes when you put the optical flow on there, it does start to stutter. And if it starts to stutter, you might have to render it. But that's because it's harder work. It's trying to invent frames as opposed to just blending them together. Let's have a look at some more examples. Here we have a shot of a guy who's walking past a train, and you can notice there, if I just pause it for a second, although he's going past the camera, he's got some motion blur on him, but you'll notice he's a bit sharper. If you look at it closely, he is actually coming out a bit sharper on this shot, and the surroundings are a bit sharper than they are on the frame blended shot. This is because the frame blending is crossfading them together, so it's always a little bit more blurred. I mean, you cannot see here the other variation of slow motion, which is just repeating frames. That comes out as sharp as the original. Frame blending was always a bit blurrier. Well, optical flow goes back to very close to the sharpness of just repeating frames, but hopefully giving you better looking slow motion. You can see here looking at this guy, yeah, he looks a bit better there. He's a bit sharper on the frame blending. He's a bit double vision-y. If I just pop back and play that again, you'll also notice I am getting some warping around him. That juddering warping. I noticed it comes out really badly on areas where there's a high degree of contrast, like between this very light grey jumper and the dark train, and also things like vertical lines. Doesn't seem to be able to cope with those very well. Of those two, which is better? I'm not sure. That juddering as he goes past here, I'm not too happy with. I prefer everything else about it. If you go and look at some more examples, this one, I think there's a bit more detail. Slightly sharper on the optical flow version than it is on the frame blending version, and I've got no artifacts. It looked fine. This shot of a bus outside Brighton Pavilion. We're in Brighton in England. You'll notice the bus there looks really, really nice. Most of the cars there is fine, and then as soon as we get a great big white van coming across, some really peculiar things are happening down here in the railings. Here comes another one. Again, high contrast areas and verticals. Optical flow isn't too happy with that. So I am getting some artifacts, and there's nothing you can do about it. There are no settings inside of it currently. It either works and you like the look of it, or you use frame blending, or you use nearest neighbour. We go to the next example. Close up of Ringo. That looks fine. And this example in particular is showing optical flow off, I think, really well. Particularly this guy's shirt, which is quite hard work. Lots of detail on it, so it's the sort of thing that might cause you a problem. Well, that is working really well. This is coming out. This is a little bit sharper. I mean, you might not be seeing this sharpness on the YouTube video, because I don't know what your final results are going to be like once YouTube has mushed it up. But basically, I can tell you by looking at this myself on a nice big 50-inch screen pumped out through the Blackmagic gizmo, this definitely looks a little bit sharper than the frame blended version. It doesn't really produce any major artifacts. It's working really, really well on that shot. Whereas here, there's quite a lot of juddering inside of it. Looking at this guy here, it's a lot smoother there. This is just a handheld shot in an underground train station. Nothing fancy about it. Now, all these shots that I've been looking at, they are interlaced. Actually, the first one is a 50p AVCHD shot. This one is AVCHD at 50i, and then I've got some HDV shots as well. I found optical flow works better if you're working with things like 50i or 50p footage. If you try it on 25p footage, it's not so good. So here I've got a shot of a guy who is surfing on a river, and it's all done at 25p. So this is actually filmed on a GH4 camera at 4K at 25p. And I've slowed it down in three different ways. So the one at the bottom is optical flow, the next one up is frame blending, and then the one at the top is just nearest neighbour. I've got it running here at either 30%, or the second lot is done at 10%. Now if I start that playing, there you can see the nearest neighbour version. You see how stuttery it is, because it's repeating frames? But on the other hand, there's no artifacts, it's nice and clear, but it's just very, very stuttery. Let's pop it into frame blending, and you look at that, and oh, that's actually pretty awful. It's not coming out nearly as well as the interlace footage does. Now the problem here is 25p footage. When you're using 50i or 50p footage, you've got 50 pictures a second. As soon as you've only got 25 pictures a second, there's a lot less stuff in there to slow down or to frame blend. So 25p footage, when it's frame blended, looks like that. It's almost like the non-frame blended version, but with echoes. Let's try the same thing with optical flow. I mean, a lot of that is better. The water is looking really nice and smooth. The only problem I've got is him. His head juddering backwards and forwards. Or here, I'm still getting that kind of same echoing I got with frame blending, except it's juddering around a lot. That's what it does. You know, these are the options you've got. Here's the same thing at 10%. So there's the optical flow version, frame blended version, and repeated frames. You notice how now I've gone down to 10%. It's repeating so many frames. That's not slow motion, is it? That's like a strobe shot or something. I'd say the optical flow probably produces the best results. It's also producing stuff I don't like. I don't like what's happening around his body. The thing is, optical flow isn't perfect. I've got it in four different programs that I use quite regularly. I've got it in Avid, Premiere, Resolve, and EDIUS. The one that's in Premiere was originally taken from After Effects. I mean, it was only put into Premiere in about CC 2015. Before that, it was only available in After Effects, and it's been in After Effects for several years. So you're looking at something there which has been around and refined for ages. If you look at the same clip done in Premiere, I see the frame blending comes out pretty much the same, maybe worse than EDIUS. The optical flow, yeah, it's a little bit better. There's a little bit less of strange things going on around his body. At 10% there, yep, optical flow definitely better in Premiere, although there were a few odd things happening with his hand. Here's the same thing in EDIUS. Comparing it to the Resolve one, again, Resolve has optical flow for 2 or 3 years. This is the Resolve one, and next to it you can see the EDIUS one. Let's go to this shot of the guy in the train station. So this is 50i footage in Resolve with all the interlacing options ticked and at the same speed as the EDIUS one, and there is some weird stuff going on the back of his jumper. Resolve is not doing as good a job on this one as EDIUS does.